Hey y'all, Surfing Sapo here. Today we're going to start a process. We're going to make fermented habanero hot sauce. Sounds interesting, doesn't it? Does to me at least. So what we'll do is pick the habaneros, not on camera. I grow them in my yard. Then we'll cut them, we'll mash them up, we'll add some other ingredients. And then we'll let them ferment for about 4, 5, 6 days, whatever, until we think it's time to pickle them or bottle them. But anyway, enough of that. Just watch the video and you'll see how to do it, okay? So let's get started. Okay, let's get after this. First, let me show you what we have. We have all these habaneros that I got off my bushes. I've taken the stems off. The seeds are still in there. Everything's in there. We're going to mix them with about 4 large garlic cloves. We can just start putting these in here. And then I got a bell pepper that's pretty much the same color. That'll give it some little bit of more flavor. And what this is the ninja. And we're just going to use that for now to chop it up. We have other ingredients, but we're not going to put them in yet. Let's see how it goes. Just like that. See? Now start dropping these bad boys in. Make sure you have gloves and a respirator. I don't have a respirator, but I don't plan on sniffing this too much. Put as many as you can get up in there. There's no rules, remember? We're just cooking. This is gonna definitely put a little bit of water for good measure. Distilled or filtered water. Okay, put the lid back on. Ninja. We don't want to frappe it to liquid yet. Ooh. Don't touch that stuff, whatever you do. You can touch with the gloves. Ooh, yeah, pungent. I smell it. If I start coughing, forgive me. Gotta get back here. Hold on. Very strong. We're not gonna probably use all of these. These all came off my plant, by the way. How interesting. Okay. Now we're gonna add some sugar and salt. About a tablespoon of each. I picked brown sugar. And add a little bit more water. You can chop the peppers up first too if you would like to make them fit in better. It's up to you. Hold on. Make sure this is level. Okay. Get ready, folks. Now the fun part. Oh boy. There we go. Okay. What I got over here, which I'm going to bring into the pitcher, is this. I'm going to dump it into there now. And then do a little bit more. It's just mash at this point. I'm glad we didn't throw this away. We got a Vitamixer, but we didn't get rid of this. Look at that. Ooh. I'm gonna do some more and add it to this now. Boy, that's, you can smell the heat in that right now. Woo. Okay, we're gonna add some more in here now. I might as well use them all. I've been eating these actually raw, right off the bush. And they put a hurt to you. Okay, that's enough for that. All right, put this back on there. Well, maybe add some water. Water helps it. We've already added the salt sugar to the other one. Okay. Okay. Put some more. We're almost getting towards the end now. You get the point, right? It's gonna be good, man. Everything's good to a certain point. Come on, boy. This thing is fitted. There. Again. Don't rub that in your eyes, whatever you do. Get over here. Put it up in there. Woo! Mash. Same thing. One more time. Just a couple more yet. Get in there, fellas. That's it. The last of the water. Put the lid on. There we go. Let me give it a minute. Okay. And we're done. Well, we're not done, but we're done with this stage. Put that in there. We can get this out of here. Wash this as soon as possible. And wash your hand while you're at it. The reason you want to wash that plastic thing is the habanero will... It'll burn the plastic. It's so strong. So kind of push it down in there like that, mix it around, I guess. Get that, the one with the sugar and the salt to mix with the other. Like that. Ooh, it smells good already. Then you're just gonna put it inside this bag like this. Inside a baggie and seal this almost to the end like that. Just leave a tiny hole, and then you're going to set this in somewhere in the house away from your children, your pets, your wife, maybe in a back bedroom in a closet, and let it ferment for about a week, 5 to 7 days. So I'll see you. Oh, by the way, stir it every day just a little bit to get the stuff on the top to go down. Okay, it's been 24 hours. Let's give it a little mix. Get it out of here. Looks like we're getting a lot of juice now. Can smell the fermentation. Doesn't smell too bad. Getting some bubbles. That's a good sign. Woo! That's strong. Give it a good mix. Everybody get to know each other. Look at all that fermentation. It's only been 24 hours. It's got the sugar and the salt in there. And just a tad bit of water. All right. Let's smooth it, tap it down. Man, I wish you could smell this. We'll put it back in here again. Carefully, of course. Very carefully. You don't want to spill this precious gold like that. It's now been 48 hours. Smelling unbelievably awesome. Actually, the house smells good. But my wife doesn't even know I'm doing this. I'm going to, probably today she's going to say, what's that smell? And I have to tell her I'm fermenting habaneros with garlic. Are we getting some good bubbles yet? And the smell is just off the chart, man. So put it back, give it another 3 days. We'll see how it is by then. And I think it'll be ready to frappe. Well, I skipped one day. I did stir it, but I didn't film. So here we have it again, stirring it up. And the smell isn't, it's not bubbling anymore. I think it's done fermented. It doesn't smell. I mean, it smells, but it doesn't smell as strong as it did the few days ago. And it doesn't seem to make me want to sneeze or cough, like pepper spray. So I'm thinking one more day, which will be 5 days. So next scene, we will blend this up into a liquid. And I'm waiting for some bottles to come in, but we might have to make a separate video for that. So there you have it. Let's just get these down there and we'll put it up again. And I don't have gloves on because I'm being careful. Well, the day is finally here that we're gonna finish this up. So here we have about 32 ounces of the actual concoction. And I wanna pour it in, but I'm kinda scared. So I guess we can be very careful. I want it to splatter. I'm not wearing gloves, as you can see. It's really just a mash at this point. Don't touch this, whatever you do. Okay, there we have it. Right here we have a half a cup apple cider vinegar. I shook it up, took it out of the fridge, and got a half a cup. So we'll add a half a cup, which is 4 ounces, to this. Get it on there. Smells good too. Now this is the Ninja also. This is the Ninja. It's more of a pitcher. Put this on. I don't know if it locks. I guess it just sits on there like that. Get the Ninja power head here. Put it on there. Let me zoom y'all in a little bit. Okay, here goes nothing, folks. We're going to try to get this very fine because I ordered these bottles, these little bottles, and they have just a tiny hole on top. So we're going to see how fine we can get this. I have a Vitamix blender too, but I don't want to use it for this. We'll let it go for a minute or so. I want the seeds to completely be demolished. And I don't know if this Ninja can do that. I hope it can. Looks like it can't. Maybe it'll take a while. Nope. Boy, you could sure smell that. Yeah, now they're getting smaller. All right, we might have to use the Vitamixer. It can grind anything up. Let's see what we got. Like I said, be very careful. Let's see what we got. Still have seeds and it's still kind of pulpy. I'm gonna switch over to the Vitamixer and just do it real quick. and then get it out of it because I don't want it to destroy the plastic. Okay, here it is. It's going in the Vitamix. And this thing will definitely make it into a liquid. So we'll put the top on and hopefully it doesn't destroy the deal. All right, turn it on right here. Start slow, faster, 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 faster. That's real fast. Take a look. I believe that's better. Let's just do it one more time for grins and giggles, shall we? We'll give it a good 30 seconds. Much better, look at that. All right, well, I'm gonna put it back in the other one just for pouring, and I'm gonna clean this out real fast. Okay, here's the bottle with the little funnel in there. Not a little funnel. This is actually a little funnel. I'm debating on which one to use. Maybe we should use the little funnel. Fits in there a little better. And here's the hot sauce. It's very, very runny. Which is good. See? Goes in nice. Well, it did. Houston, we have a problem, or do we? Excuse me. I think it's a airlock or whatever you call it. That's cool. Put in less. There we go. It's like airlock. Let's just put a little bit at a time then. No, that ain't gonna work. Woo! The aroma, y'all. Let's go like this. It's only 5 ounces. Gonna have to find a better way because this is tedious. Coming along. But this is just a little bit too tedious for me and for you probably. Yeah, that's a pain in the butt. But what can you say? What can you do? A little bit more and I'm not gonna fill it to the top. Let's just go with that, okay? And then we can hurt ourselves for the taste test. This first bottle going in the fridge right away. Well, after we eat some. All right, we're almost there. Perfect. All right, then what you do, which I don't know if I can use this. You got these little guys right here, and then a cap. So let me take this off. Put it over there. Pop this on. And then put this on. And then for this one, I'm not going to seal it. But for the other ones, I'm going to seal them like this. Put that on and put a air dryer, blow dryer, hair dryer or whatever, and it will shrink this. And then the person just pulls out and opens it. So here we have it, some fermented habanero hot sauce. So you know what time it is now, folks. It's taste test time. Oh boy. Shiver me timbers. Well, we did it. Took about 5 to 6 days, but we did it. And here's the results. Beautiful, huh? Nice and orange, like a habanero. So we shall put some on here. About that much right there. Can you see it? And we shall set this down first, in case of an emergency. Wow, that is delicious. And it's hot, but it's not as hot as just eating one fresh off the bush. That hurts. I guess the fermentation lowers the heat a tiny bit. That's delicious. Wow, that's good. I got all kinds of other pepper bushes, so this is my harvest from the habaneros. I got a few more. I'm gonna get them going again, but that's a good recipe right there. You could go to HEB and get habaneros, or you could get jalapeno, serrano, whatever you like, and do the exact same thing I just did. It takes a couple days, but it's well worth it, man. All right, and the video is the recipe pretty much. I mean, I can make a makeshift recipe, but I guess I should, for the people that don't want to watch it and just go straight to the description. That'd be cool. But yeah, man, that's delicious. All right, well, thanks. And I got the quail, so I'll be making quail pretty soon. All right, then. Thanks for watching. Make you some hot sauce. It's really, really good. See, I'm not turning red. I'm not sweating. I'm not going, give me milk. The raw ones, oh, boy, that hurts. All right, then. Subscribe, like, comment, all of the above, none of the above. It's up to y'all. We'll see you next time. God bless you and adios, amigos.